is a competition with yourself.
Basketball means the world to me, man. It reminds me so much of life, how it has your ups and downs.
I would say volleyball means everything, honestly. It means a lot more than just a sport to me.
Soccer is, you know, one of those sports with just no better feeling.
Just pure enjoyment, I guess.
Baseball and softball is a game of trial and error. You go 3 for 10 and that's good.
Soccer, kicking the soccer ball, and it's just the feeling of having the ball at your feet.
My favorite quote is, "Don't let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game." Babe Ruth.
My sport is basically the framework of my life.
It's the time that I get away from my life, so it's kind of like stress relieving for me.
You don't need language or you don't need anything to play. I mean, people play all over the world. You don't need much, you just need to make a ball out of anything, paper or anything.
My name is Andrew Parker.
My name is Tyler McNeely.
My name is Janae Stevenson. To me, basketball has really been a big influence in my life because without it, I wouldn't have been able to come to college.
With basketball, you go through ups and downs throughout the whole process of playing. And you learn a lot about yourself.
There's nothing better than being on the court with five guys that you love like a brother.
It's taught me confidence on and off the court. So I don't think I would have had as much confidence in myself if I didn't have basketball.
I always goofed around playing basketball, but I never played in like an organized game, so I was really excited and I actually played pretty well, so ever since then I just love basketball.
I actually do remember the first time I ever played my sport when I was 4, and it was a great feeling, man. YMCA league, we had orange jerseys, thought we were cool, you know. It's not too many kids that's really good, so you dominated that, it's pretty easy.
My name is Mari Ali, and my journey started in Helsinki, Finland. Summer breaks, school was over, all we did was just go out and literally play soccer from sunrise to sunset. And it was just about having fun. We took our shoes, put them as posts, and running around pretty much free.
My journey started pretty much as soon as I could walk. According to my parents, I was terrible. Apparently, I was so bad. That they actually sat me down and asked me, "What kind of a player do you think you are, Lauren?" "Oh, I'm the best player. I'm the best player out there." "Okay, so you really like soccer?" "Oh, I love it. I love it, Dad." And they're sitting there going, "Man, we're trying to get her to stop playing because she's terrible." I mean, even my grandfather was like, "Get that girl off the field."
Anything you invest 17 plus years of your life to, I mean, it kind of becomes such a huge part of you. Hard work, commitment, working with others, being part of a team, all of these characteristics that are part of me come from soccer.
My journey began when I was about 3 years old. My mom was a college soccer player, and growing up being in a soccer family, she introduced me to the sport and I loved it. When I was younger, I went to soccer practices just kind of to let my energy out. I was a very energetic kid, so I was all over the place. It was more of a social thing. I loved being with the girls and being able to talk and hang out with them.
Well, I first got into soccer from my dad, and because he was my youth soccer coach when I was like a little peewee, in charge of our BLOOPERS team, we were lime green. And also my older sister was like the soccer star, and I wanted to be just like her. So I did everything I could to be better than her.
It's an
work because she's amazing. But from there, I just loved the game so much, and that kind of brought me to college.
My coach in Finland at the time, we were joking around one day, and I said, hey, I kind of want to go to America. Can you hook me up? And he said, sure. And 3 months later, Justin from UNCG shows up and says, hey, you want to come play for me? And I said, okay.
It was a UNCG summer camp I was involved in, and I got the chance to meet a lot of the girls and see how they interact. And I had a really good feeling just because, you know, everyone was so close-knit. And for whatever reason, I left the camp thinking UNCG seems like the place for me.
Got a letter from UNCG and never even really heard of the school, to be honest with you, and went on the visit. A couple weeks later, hung out with the team, and that's when I knew it was all gonna start. Just remember, it was one Sunday afternoon, I was with the coach, and I was on College Avenue, and I fell in love with the place.
My name is Tyrone Austin.
My name is Chelsea Sumney.
My name is Kelly Momtak.
My name is Shannon Hall.
My name is Shayna Sumney, and I'm a member of the women's cross country and track team.
Running is a big part of my life, honestly. It's carried me very far. Sometimes you wake up and you just need to have that running there for you. You know, that's something you can always go back to. You can always look on it, and it's just your backbone.
I think the best feeling while running is what they call the runner's high, when you just run and you don't think about it, and you basically don't have any pain. Your legs are just moving and your brain's just not even thinking about it. It's a really cool feeling.
It's kind of like a dream. Sometimes you look back on longer runs, like 12 miles, and you're just kind of floating in air, and it doesn't feel like there's any, you just feel kind of effortless and just relaxed. It just feels like a dream.
What I love most about running is just going out there and pushing yourself to become something better each and every day. I've had to push myself past the limits that I didn't know I was capable of.
Yeah, you're running and your goal is to win, but in the end, you're pushing yourself as hard as you can go, and that's winning in itself.
It is a competition with yourself. So when you're able to conquer that and overcome something that you've been working on for so long, it means a great deal, it really does.
My sport means hard work for me. It's really intense and kind of overwhelming, but when you're finished, you feel like if you can conquer this, you can conquer anything.
Pushing yourself to finish those like last mile or like last 200 meters of the track, you just got to know that your training has really prepared yourself to finish your race hard and just believing in yourself and having confidence in yourself to finish.
I have had quite a few funny moments running. I've been pooped on by a bird at least twice that I can remember. It's probably more than that. I also ran into a tree one time.
I'm known for being clumsy on the team, so I pretty much this year, when there was a lot of ice, I fell about like 3 times. Running downhills on ice, I've fallen and bruised myself. I trip a lot, I fall. Not too graceful.
My name is Morgan Freeman.
My name is Kelly Orweiler.
I'm Carrie Chambers.
We were a basketball family, so I played basketball. And I had braces, and this girl busted my lip. And I told my mom, I was like, I don't want to play anymore. She's going to mess up my face. And my coach went to my dad and was like, she's kind of like girly. You might want to put her in something else. My mom was like, oh, great. She'll play volleyball.
Volleyball means to me as a person kind of describes who I am. I can be intense on the court, but off the court, I just like laugh all the time.
It means a lot more than just a sport to me. It's kind of like a way of life, just because like I really couldn't see my life without it. Just competing. Like I love to compete and I hate to lose. Being able to compete for me is just everything. Like I'm a hardcore competitor, and it's just what I love to do.
Volleyball is a very mental sport. Whenever you put all the pieces together in volleyball, you have to think of so many things. Is it set off? Is it set tight? Is the block giving me line? Is it giving me a hole? Or is it giving me a sharp cross? Should I tip in the middle or should I tip deep line? And you have to listen to people tell you those things, but yet you can't think too much, otherwise you're gonna mess up.
I actually got recruited to go to UNCG right out of high school. I saw the brochures that they send you in the mail, and they had these god-awful yellow jerseys on the front brochure, and I remember specifically handing it to my mom, telling her, I don't want this. I refuse to wear that yellow. And so I didn't come, and I went to UConn, played there for a season, did not like it. So I came here, and I came on my visit, and the first thing I asked was, do you guys still have those yellow jerseys? And coach said, no, we threw those out. And I was like, all right, we can talk.
I guess I was messing up in the game. And my coach told me, Carrion, use what you're blessed with. And then Kelly, she did the same thing. She goes, yeah, use what you're blessed with.
The best feeling for me is like getting a really hard driven hit, dig it up, and it turned into a play that we just kill back in their face. I remember this play with Carrion actually. There was a ball that got shanked back and way past our like volleyball court line.
Freakishly high ball. You couldn't even see it on the camera because it was like in the ceiling, and all of a sudden, I'll hit it somehow.
And she goes and just like crushes it down line. And it was like, we're all like, oh my gosh, like.
Stuff like that.
My journey began for softball, playing wiffle ball in the backyard with my dad.
My dad made me play for the first 2 years and I absolutely hated it. And then I kept playing and I realized I was actually decent at something other than video games. So I stuck with it.
The furthest memory I have back playing baseball is probably in T-ball when I was catching and I fell asleep during the game, because there's really no need for a catcher in T-ball since they put the ball in the tee.
My dad played as a kid, and he influenced me to play. Furthest memory back was when I was hit in the head with a bat and had to get 8 stitches, and then I didn't play for like 6 years after that.
It all started when I was a walk-on here at UNCG. I did tryouts and all that, and my first day was the day after tryouts, and Dylan Hathcock was standing in the dugout, and he goes, and you are not very big, so we're gonna call you Tiny. And it all started there, and it just caught on. Coaches started calling me that, and everybody on campus knows me as Tiny now.
If I didn't play softball ever, I think that I would be pretty bored, and I wouldn't have as much fun and met a lot of great people as I've met. There was a couple weeks during my freshman year where I didn't play softball because I was walking on, and it was the most boring 3 weeks of my life.
Softball has shaped the person that I am today by making me confident, making me be able to stand up for myself and believe in myself and set goals for myself that are high and be able to know that I can achieve them.
Hitting a baseball is rather difficult. When you fail 7 out of 10 times, you're considered successful, which is kind of ridiculous, but it shows how hard it is to play the game and hit the ball consistently.
I think seeing people who maybe have been struggling, like getting that hit and you just see it in their faces where they're just like, yes. Like I know when I'm struggling, it just takes like that one hit, or like you see someone else do it and you're just like, let's go, like that's awesome. And to me that just means, it means so much more than someone getting a hit.
When it's a really bad day on the mound, I'll turn around and I look at the dance building. For some reason, I started doing it when I was a freshman here. And I'll look at the building and there's like a little circle on top of the building and I'll flush it. That's what our coach always says. You flush it, you get rid of it. You start over, move on to the next pitch and focus on the present and don't worry about the past.
This is a shout out for Coach Edwards. Only 3 things you can control in life: attitude, perspective, and enthusiasm. If you really think about it, there's only three things that you personally control over yourself.
Some of the stuff I do outside of baseball involves Team BOGO. It's a fundraising team for type 1 diabetes. I sell t-shirts and shorts and random apparel and accessories and whatnot that have funny anti-diabetes slogans, such as kick diabetes in the pancreas, die a badass, get insulin pumped, helping to eliminate pricks. A couple more, but those are the ones that come to mind.
Baseball swagger. Well, a lot of people consider it to be looking good in your uniform, which Hunter King does not do. Just want to throw that out there.
The swag a baseball player has, like their charisma on the field, just the way they walk, they wear, they have chain, Evo shield, stirrups, you know, batting stance, high leg kick, something that distinguishes you from others.
My name is Ahmet Sarıoğlu.
My name is Dilara Yurtkuran. I'm from Istanbul, Turkey. I remember the first time I played tennis. I was really young, and it was something like I didn't know what I was really doing, but I was definitely enjoying it.
Me and tennis were like a married couple. We had bad days and good days, so we've been together for 16 years.
Tennis is an individual sport, so you're by yourself on the court. And you're the only person who can help yourself. So to be able to handle the situation, you always have to control your emotions and always find another way when things are not going right.
It's not a team sport, so you're kind of individual on the court, so you have to figure your opponent, the game, and how to play by yourself.
The best feeling while I'm playing tennis is being able to leave 100% on my effort on the court.
When you're down, like, let's say 5-1 in the third or 5-2 in the third, that's like huge being down, so. And then you come back and win the match. And that feeling is perfect. You just feel like you got your opponent and then you crush them on the court.
I guess my sport means everything to me. It's how I release all my anger. Take it out on the court. Definitely just helps me get through all the struggles of life.
I would say that people definitely underestimate just the toughness of tennis mentally. I think it is extremely tough, just having to refocus after every point.
Probably the most challenging thing is being focused. You have to concentrate on hitting a little tiny ball going 100 miles an hour every single time. It's tough. Like, you gotta really stay focused and be mentally strong throughout the entire match or else you'll get beat.
If I was younger and I could see myself today playing college tennis, I would think just of how much I've grown. I really used to be kind of timid on the court, and I would say that I've grown a lot in my sport and just having confidence in my abilities.
My journey to UNCG really began with looking for the right school that fit me, not really how I fit the school. It really felt like this was a home for me.
It's just a family feel to it, and that was one thing that really attracted me to this school and this program.
I instantly fell in love with the campus, the team, the coaches, and just the atmosphere. It's a little hidden treasure.
It was quite a long journey to UNCG for me, but it was worthwhile as soon as it happened.
I think this is where God wanted me to be, kind of opened the door like to where it was pretty clear. Like, UNCG is where you're supposed to be. I can remember 4 years ago when I signed on the dotted line, I was like, yeah, this is a good decision.
It's just a long line of success, so I knew coming to UNCG I would have success and it would give me the opportunity to do well.
I wanted to play at the highest level possible, so I decided to come down here as a walk-on, just play at a high level, and you know, I really had a great experience.
If I could have seen myself where I am now, I think my mind would be blown. You know, 4 years ago, I never in a million years would be thinking I'd play Division I baseball.
Not playing basketball would be heartbreaking, because over the years, I didn't love it, but I've grown to love it throughout college.
I don't think I would be the same person without soccer today. I think just being involved in soccer has made me extremely competitive, even in an academic standpoint.
I don't know what kind of person I would be. I think definitely my sense of humor would totally be different, and I'd probably be a more serious person.
I think soccer has taught me to be a better person, and it drives me. I'm very competitive, and even with like now with teaching, I'm a PE teacher, and I'm always driven. I always want to get up in the morning and teach my kids, and I always want to teach them to the best of my ability, just as if I was on the soccer field.
I'm really thankful for just the sport and how it's impacted my life, teaching me how to be a better teammate, teaching me how to work well with people, and really just to get out there and enjoy winning and playing.
It's taught me never give up. I mean, with sports for that long, you go through a lot of obstacles. Persevere, go after what you want.
Chase your dreams no matter what it is, no matter how difficult you seem it can be. You know, just to try until you've given it your all and you've given it your best.
You don't always see the results you want to. You just have to know that it can get better. You just got to keep practicing, take each day at a time, and you're going to get there.
You always have to come in with a good attitude, and you know, you'll be okay.
Something that my assistant coach, Abby, said to me one time when I was struggling, she said, you know, in order to get better, you have to learn to be uncomfortable. And being uncomfortable is how you improve.
Pressure is like medicine. Take it to get better. That quote basically just means that there's a lot of pressure, and if you don't do it, you're never gonna get anywhere. You're not, never gonna get better. You gotta take chances, especially if you wanna develop as a player or as a person. You gotta take chances in your life. Faith is taking the first step, even though you don't see the whole staircase. And it's by Martin Luther King Jr. You never really know what's gonna happen in the future, but what you have to do is just take that first initiative and just take it. You know, you never know where it's going to lead you, but at the same time, you're not going to know if you don't do it.
My favorite and most inspirational quote would have to be from the boxer Floyd Mayweather. It's basically just hard work and dedication. Stay dedicated to your runs, to waking up early, to making sure your body's fit, dedication to your teammates, dedication to your family.
My favorite quote, it's by Ralph Waldo Emerson. What lies behind you and what lies before you are tiny matters compared to what lies within you. The quote means that no matter what your circumstances are and no matter what you've been through in the past, that you can create your own future. You have the power to change whatever you need to be changed.
And one last chance to play the game of basketball. We'd definitely be in an NCAA tournament somewhere. I don't know where it would be, it didn't really matter to me. As long as we was there, just to make some noise in the bracket. So. That'd be good enough for me.
Wimbledon tennis courts, because that's my favorite tournament. It will be against Andre Agassi, because people tell me I look like him.
If I had one last chance to play, I'd definitely choose Wimbledon. Wimbledon final against Federer, because he's my idol.
Well, there's kind of two sides to it. One side is obviously would be a World Cup where the entire world can see me play, and that would be a dream come true. And another one would probably be just me just at the backyard again with my friends, just having a laugh.
So if I had one last chance to play, I'd do the same thing. I'd play here, not on this field, but I'd play at UNCG with this team.
Off the court, the best moments have definitely been being around my teammates and all the dumb stuff that we do.
Best memories I've had throughout college is just being with my teammates, having fun with them on and off the field.
After our coaches just killed us in running, we all just like kind of support each other and pick each other up off the ground if somebody's on the ground dying. We just pick each other up, and we're just always there for each other. I think really close-knit team.
That's the best thing about being an athlete. That's having a team around you, having somebody who picks you up when you fall down.
Every volleyball team that I've been on, you know, we have just so much fun together, and those memories that we've made are irreplaceable and unforgettable.
Yeah, I don't think I ever really walked to class by myself, never ate a meal by myself. I was always with someone, and it was always on my team, and I knew I could always go to them for anything.
I mean, they're lifelong relationships and coaches, and things that we've got to do as a team are memories that you'll never forget.
They're family. They're always going to be family, whether they like it or not. And whether we fight in vigor, they're always going to be there.
Whether it's been dancing or singing or just getting excited because we get ice cream or something silly, those surpass any kind of on-court moment, I think, because I'm going to remember that for the rest of my life.
I can remember times when we stayed in the locker room for 2-3 hours, just, you know, always joking on each other and just having fun, man. Like, I love all these guys like brothers.
The relationships I've built because of baseball, I met so many good friends.
There's a lot of people that I know I'll be in contact with for the rest of my life.
I'm really going to miss being a part of a team. Leadership, teamwork, enthusiasm, passion, everything I've gotten from my teammates.
Every day, man, every day I had a blast with these guys.
There have been so many people that have helped me become a better athlete and a person, whether it be my teammates, the coworkers, friends, professors, coaches, everyone. I can't even pinpoint just one person, honestly.
I mean, my twin sister has played a significant role in my running career for sure. I mean, without her, I probably wouldn't be where I'm at today.
My coaches right now, especially, they support me a lot. My mom and my dad worked with me since I was about 6 years old. In the backyard, he watched videos for me and read books on pitching so that he could teach me.
I'm definitely going to continue playing soccer in some avenue.
But I think it's going to be really hard to let go of the sport, but I plan on keeping running when I'm done.
I definitely will continue to run, but one thing I'll miss the most is the atmosphere of being around my teammates and just that camaraderie that we all have together. It's gonna be sad not having to wake up for practice, but then missing being with those people you see every day.
Something I would tell my teammates is just to not give up and make the best of it that you can.
Enjoy it, it goes by fast, and learn from your mistakes.
Stay unified, don't let anything get in between you guys, because team chemistry is what wins games.
Don't take it for granted and live in the moment. You never know what's going to happen, what's going to change.
There's always going to be ups and downs, and there's going to be times when you hate it and times when you love it, but I just think learning to persevere.
Just remember how much you love the sport, how much you want to play it. Think of what really matters.
One last thing I would say to my teammates is thank you for all the memories and on the court and off the court.
Time's very limited, so really get your work done when you got the chance and just have fun with it, because once it's over, it's over.
Like I said, I can remember signing on the dotted line 4 years ago, but now I'm here, you know, doing senior memoirs.
I mean, I've been here for 5 years and it seems like just yesterday we're moving into Wheel Winfield.
I don't think I would have changed anything. I like where I am now, and you know, everything happens for a reason.
I have no regrets. I thought I definitely made the right choice.
I wouldn't say I regret anything. I may have done things differently, but I don't regret anything.
It's been such a great ride, and I wouldn't change it for anything. I have no regrets, and everything has been a learning opportunity and a positive experience for me here. So I really appreciate everything that UNCG has done for me.
I would describe my journey overall as worthwhile. It was worth it to come across the country.
Being that's the end of my journey, at least for collegiate soccer, it's definitely bittersweet.
I think a new chapter of my journey is beginning, and I think I had a great experience at UNCG.
You know, basketball is the greatest sport, I believe, in the world, so I've been blessed to play it these 4 years at UNCG.
Definitely, just some amazing things you can take from playing a college sport, and I'm really thankful for that.
My journey here at UNCG has been a great experience. It's been a great opportunity for me to meet new people and just make friendships that'll last forever.
And then it doesn't feel sad. I feel pretty good about it. Like, I'm so excited to go on, to move on.
I've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed the journey.
And it was a blast.
UNCG is great, and I'm so happy that I got to meet everyone that I did and to make all the friends that I did with every team. And I love you all.
Thank you. Take two.
Oh, I'm gonna cry.
I'm gonna cry.
Okay.
They call me help. They call me Stacy. My name is Caitlin Bedwell. I'm a senior.
I'm from Tampa, Florida. I'm a baseball player and I started playing in the sunny, warm weather of Tampa, Florida. I already said I was from Tampa, Florida. Why did I repeat Tampa, Florida? Should I start over?
Well, firstly, you know, I forgot the name. Cut that out.
Did they ask me first? I'll just say it, okay.
Oh my god, I just said okay.
Oh my god, wait, hold on. Life journey is not to arrive at the grave safely.
One question. Yeah. Will you stop?
My dad got me into playing baseball.
I have nothing to say about it. Like, my dad played as a kid, and he influenced me to play, and so I did. Next question.
I don't know what I'm gonna say next.
Dang it, Rick.
All right, ask me a question again. That one's long. That's a long story, Rick. I do not know how to answer that one.
I had never played soccer before. 2 months before I got recruited by UNCG, I got a phone call from Justin, our coach, while I was ice fishing, and we jumped on the next iceberg and just floated to North Carolina. Just kidding.
I played at UNCG.
Get out of the background.
I was very uncoordinated, and I chased a lot of butterflies. That's all it really was. I just chased things, and I didn't really play much soccer.
The only inspirational quote I can think of is something my dad says to me all the time, and it's just, you the man.
If I was younger and I saw who I am now, I don't know, I'd probably be like, wow, that's a crazy guy right there. No, I'm just kidding.
My life would be a lot different. I'd probably be fat right now.
I'd probably be a cook or something. I have no clue, really.
See, I'd probably pick up a basketball or a football, because I like those sports as well.
Like, I couldn't even picture, like, if I ever even have kids, their sports will be a part of their life, probably whether they're good at it or not.
I would definitely be smoking cigarettes somewhere if I was not playing soccer. You can cut that out, man. Don't include that.
No, never mind. Wait, what's the question again?
Probably the most fun I've ever had is when we won cross country. The men's team won and the women's team won, so it was just, we won a lot, I don't know, scratch that.
But my other goal was also to get a ring. Yeah, we didn't get it.
Best feeling on the field is when the game's over and everybody gets in the locker room and talks about what we're gonna do that night.
The most fun I've had, soccer parties. No, not that.
I can tell about the worst feeling is that off the field, I hate conditioning. So I'm not a conditioning guy. When we run, I always come last. I'm not ripped, but I can play.
Worst feeling, grand slams.
Worst feeling on the field is when you show up that day and your arm's not feeling quite right and you just kind of feel like not doing anything, and so you just don't get any better that day.
Something poetic about soccer. Well, I always tell the ladies, it's the war out there, all right? We might not all make it back alive. It's very intense, so just be ready, all right?
The best feeling on the soccer field is definitely scoring a goal. I can't even describe how that feels. Just like better than orgasm. I can't say that.
The best feeling on the diamond is probably when you're pitching and you just, you know, you gave it your all, seven innings.
I've learned that you should, You should never eat the calf before playing a doubleheader. Never, ever, ever become go late to weights because coach will make you run. Never take 4 years of Spanish because Spanish 204 is the hardest thing you will ever do in your life.
My favorite quote, shout out to Coach Edwards. Sometimes you're the bug, sometimes you're the windshield. You ain't back yet.
Because he'll tell you to go do something, and as you start running away to do it, he will start yelling at you and expect you to already be done.
The most challenging moment on the soccer field is definitely when you don't understand what the coach is saying to you. You're on the field and he's like yelling at you and you're like, oh, okay. And you have no idea what he was saying. And then afterwards, he's like, what were you doing, man? And you're like, I couldn't hear you. But it's awesome.
What I'm thinking about when I'm hitting, well, it's better when I don't think.
Baseball and I have a love-hate relationship, something that I strive to get better at each and every day, and it's something that also drives me crazy. Gotta do all sorts of things for it. Probably shouldn't say. Baseball and I have a love-hate relationship.
I had one last chance to play the game. It will be in the Grand Canyon. We'll be playing in the sunrise, and Beyonce will be dancing, the music. It would just be a magical moment in the Grand Canyon.
The last thing I'd say to my teammates as a captain.
Let's go! Love all you got, or no, I want to say love you guys. Hate you guys. Just kidding. I love everybody. Nah, I'm gonna miss everybody, and see you later.